Assalamu alaikum, my dear students of class 6. This is your teacher, Ms. Yusra Mawal, with another exciting lesson which is being organized in a virtual class by Metropolitan School. My dear students, let tell me that any 5 animals that are kept as pet. There should be dog, goat, cat, cow and a sheep, right? So all these 5 animals people can easily keep as a pet. So which one are the most popular? So I might feel like cat and dog are the popular one. So what do you think, pets are common only in cities or in the urban areas? So yes, pets should be kept cities as well as in the villages, right? So do you have any pet? Do you have any pet around you? Do you have any pet at your home? Yes, I have a pet. I have a pet dog. So what do you think, that to keep a pet is something expensive or not? I don't think, as per my experience, that it is being too much expensive. So my dear students, let's have another question in my mind. That are the snakes being a good pet? I don't think so. That snakes and the wild animals are being a good pet. Even though not a mouse. So do you think that goat or sheep makes a good pet? What do you think about it? I think yes, it is. Because goat and sheep both are very useful pets. So, do you know anyone who keep pigeons, and what about parrots, whom we may call mittu? Yes, mostly people can keep them as a pet as well. So, my dear students, why am I asking you such type of question regarding pets or regarding animals? What do you think, why am I asking that? Because our chapter is the care of animals. That is why I am asking you about pets. In this lesson, we are gonna study about that how we keep our pets. Right, my dear students? So let's start our lesson, the care of animals. Starting from, in the starting passage of this chapter, in this lesson, there should be, you people may know about 2 things. Number one is SPCA, that is the Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, and the other one is PAW, P-A-W, that is the Pakistan Animal Welfare, right? Firstly, we should know about those things. What does these 2 organizations do? This is a society which is common name, and this is the non-profit animal organization around the world, and the oldest SPCA organization is the PSPCA before, and which one was founded in England in 1824, right? So basically you can say that the it founded in England in 1824. And what about PAWS? PAWS is basically the Pakistan Animal Welfare Society, and it coordinates help for animals in need, and it is non-profit organization as well, founded in 2004 and runs by the volunteers. And do you know that we have the vet, whom we may call the vet? Vet are those people, vet are those doctors basically, who treated animals. Right? So whenever our animal or our pet got ill, they are being suffered, they ill and they injured, we can take them to the vet. Right? So these are the 3 most important things that we should know about the animals. We should know about the organizations that are working for the animals. As we human are also needed the hospitals, and we human are also needed the welfare organization. So this is the need of that time. Of today's time as well, that these type of welfare organizations should be established, right? So So there are two animals which they may discuss, that is dog and the other one is cat. So how can you keep the dog and how can you keep the cat? So there are some points which are written and in this chapter they have discussed that what are those points are that dogs do not give dogs scraps food from the table. Everyone needs, every human being, every living thing needs a good food to live healthy, a good food to live alive, right? So do not give any of the scrap food, the food which is remain after you eat. So do not give dog the scrap food, do not give them from the table, right? So it's a need of a dog that should be given 2 meals a day and not more than that. We should have the biscuits, we should have the pet food as well in some of the stores. So there should be dog biscuits as well, and which can be bought cheaply, right? So dog need meat and sometimes fish, but fish should be given, be careful about the bones of the fish, right? So once a week give them a boiled liver, a raw meat should be given. Dogs really like the large bone. We have seen so many cartoons, we have seen so many videos regarding that dog really like the large bone, so give it to them. Every human being, every living thing needs plenty of fresh water to drink, so give it to them. Should be clean, should be kept in a dry box in which they have to sleep. So there is a box, like we have seen this type of dog house in so many cartoons. We have seen in a very famous cartoon that is Tom and Jerry, to keep the dog in such type of box or kennel. Yes, I have a pet dog and I keep him in such type of dry box, and should be clean. As you know, cleanliness is very important in our religion as well, not only for the human being but for the animals as well. We should clean our pets, right? So regular exercises should also be the need of the animals. So which type of exercises they need, what you will have to do with the exercise. What I have done with my dog, I go at the rooftop and I play with my dog. I throw the ball at the other side and then he picked up the ball. Like this type of some simple exercises which I have done with my dog. So he, the dog feel really fresh, the dog feel healthy. So its coat should be brushed daily, it should be given regular bath, it should be brushed daily. So these are the basic things which are also very much important for the human being as well as for the animal, to be clean, to be healthy, to be safe, to have plenty of fresh water, to have a good food and to be clean, right, my dear students? So these are things which when you have a dog, you should keep in your mind that you should do these things with the dogs. Now let's moving towards the another animal, that is cat. What does a cat need? Cat also need a plenty of fresh water, meat, fish. It also need that. Sometimes we are giving the vegetables, but this is for the sometimes. Cat needs more what? Cat more needs fresh milk. You can give the milk to the cat every day. You can give obviously the fresh water and three times meals a day. You can keep the cat also clean. You can keep them in a proper space, in a proper box, or you can make the house for them. So these are the basic needs to keep the animals. So that is all we discussed in this chapter about two animals, that are dog and the cat. So there is no room to discuss here how to look after all the pet animals. So what you will have to do, that you will have to go to your library and found some book which is on pets and how can you keep your pets, right? And if there isn't one, you will find source things in that encyclopedia, which is usually gives good advice on this subject. So what all animals need to be given the right kind of food and care, as we already discussed the cats and dogs. So we have seen the needs of both the two animals are same mostly, right? And if you want to keep them healthy and happy, you can take good care of them, you can give good food to them. And it doesn't matter whether your pet is a dog, cat, rabbit or mouse. If it is healthy, it will give you more pleasure and you will be feel proud of it, right? So there is another advice for you people, that when you are choosing and when you are selecting your pet, you should be careful about that your pet is not harmful for you and for others as well. Like I have seen so many people that are keeping cubs or lions as a pet, and I'm not feeling that the lion, the snakes, the crocodiles, these type of animals becoming a good pet. No, a big no for those animals. So while you are selecting, while you are choosing your pet, just keep it in your mind that pets should not be that much harmful, it should not be that much suitable, and should be kept in a small house. Right, my dear students? So this is all about this lesson. Now let's moving towards the exercises. So in text exercises, in text portion, you will have to do the exercise A of page number 111, in which you will have to write the full form of SPCA, and exercise B of page number 111, you will have to write each of these statements which is true or untrue or sometimes true. Like we have done the exercises of true or untrue, but this is for the first time that we are gonna write sometimes true. Like it should not be true every time, it should not be false every time, but in between, like sometimes true, right? So let's moving towards next. There are some grammar exercises as well. Exercise A of page number 112, in which you will have to finish the sentences and be careful to use the. So where we can use, I already discussed with you when we were, I taught you the articles, that the will be used while we are using the superlative degrees of adjectives. So while you are using that, you can be careful about the usage of the. Exercise of page number 113. Finish these sentences by adding a phrase beginning with for. You will have to finish the sentences. You will have to finish the sentences by adding, by starting your phrase with for. Right? Right, my dear students? So there is a home assignment for you, that you will have to do the vocabulary meanings, phrases, idioms meaning, phrasal verb meaning in your text copy. You will have to do exercise A and B of page number 111 in your text copy. You will have to do exercise A of page number 102 in your grammar copy, and exercise of page number 113 in your grammar copy. Right, my dear students? I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Allah Hafiz.